Beloved, we are looking at our faith scorecard. How has your faith done? The Lord our God is with us. He's promised never to leave us nor forsake us. The question then we need to ask is, why? You remember I had a sermon series, what is the devil doing in your land? It was a while back that I had that. But look at, I'm excited about the house of Joseph because they too had some successes. So we talked about the failure first. We talked about Judah and the iron chariots. Then we talked about Caleb and his victory. And now we looked at the Benjamites and how they settled. Now let's talk about the house of Joseph. We're going to look at the 12 tribes, you see, and then we'll see how you're doing. How are you doing at your church? How are you doing at home? How are you doing in your relationships? How are you doing on your job, your employment? How are you doing in your church? How has your faith done? That's the scorecard we're looking at. And the house of Joseph, they also went up against Bethel. Remember, Bethel was where Jacob slept on the stone and had the encounter. The Lord was with them. And the house of Joseph sent to descry Bethel. Now, the name of the city before was Luz, as I referred to it. Jacob renamed it. And the spies saw a man come forth out of the city. This is something you must know, that when you have prayed to the Lord and you're trying to solve something and trying to conquer something, trying to overcome something, don't ignore a man or a woman that God will set in your path that will show up right after you pray. Remember, when David returned and found that Ziklag was invaded, burnt, their houses burnt, their wives and children, they all were taken captive. And then the people were discouraged and thought about stoning him. And David separated himself from them and encouraged himself in the Lord his God. And when he inquired of the Lord said, "Now you can go against them. Shall I pursue? Yes, pursue. Shall I recover all?" God said, "Yes, you shall recover all." And David started on the journey. But what was their first encounter? They saw a man who lay dying. And they fed the man and asked him questions. And the man swore to them, you know, if they will swear to him that he will, and not deliver him back to his master, that he will lead them to where the host was. And that's exactly what happened. The Lord was with Joseph, and they went to take on Bethel. And the very first answer God gave them was a man. You must recognize the men that God has set in your path to teach you, to warn you, to correct you. If you don't listen to them, you're going to miss God. If you don't listen to them, you're going to be destroyed. If you don't listen to them, you're going to fail at your task. May God quicken you as I'm preaching to look at even relationships you've ignored, even counsel that you've rejected, and sought out greener pastures. May God give you grace and strengthen you to sense or decipher who God has placed on your path for your breakthrough. And the spies saw a man come forth out of the city, and they said unto him, "Show us, we pray thee, the entrance into the city, and we will show thee mercy." And when he showed them the entrance into the city, they smote the city with the edge of the sword, but they let go the man and all his family. And the man went into the land of the Hittites and built a city, and called the name thereof Luz, which is the name thereof unto this day. So what do we learn? God will put people on your path to bring you to your entrance to your breakthrough. I cannot take credit for all the things God has done in my life. He used people to facilitate it. He used the pastor that I work with to bring me into aviation, into the ministry, to get to know people in this land. God has foreigners in everybody's life. Some of you, when God will use people in your life, then when after you make it, you don't acknowledge them. You sound as if you had done it all by yourself. That is not right. I remember at our, I don't know if it's 10th anniversary celebration, I acknowledged one of my friends who was instrumental. He came and walked this building with me, and we were making decrees, and we went to wood and broke the bottle of oil and decreed that nobody will buy this building. On, you know, else nobody else can buy it until I release it. And then we were in that battle for 8 months, and the week that the breakthrough came, he was with our entire leadership all night long, and we were praying together. And I've gone and thanked him and blessed him with a great offering. But do you acknowledge people that God has used in your life? You know, I know that periodically God will use one of my brothers to speak prophetically into me. He came here and told us we're governing church, and we discovered who we were. You know, you have to acknowledge people that God has used. If you reject the relationships God has placed in your life, it will cause a faith failure. Because even though you don't, you're not dependent on man, but God will use man. You trust God, you depend on God, and then you allow him to use whoever he chooses. But you cannot completely write people off. Remember, give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Shall men give into your bosom? Who have you ignored? Who are you ignoring? Who is your helper? Who did God send your way and you rejected it? And then you went off in this path and nothing has now panned out. May God help you make corrections if it's still possible. May God help you turn around if it's still possible. And may you find your breakthrough as Joseph found. He showed them the entrance into the city, and they smote the city with the edge of the sword, but they let go the man and all his family. So Joseph received her reward. So how is your faith doing? I know that I've come a long way and I've received a whole lot of things God has promised, but there's still a whole lot ahead of me that I have not received, and I'm pushing. Join us. You will win. Amen and amen. God bless you.